see that. So in order that, you know, for, I don't want to say fraud, but for untoward situations, for the tallying, we have to be sure that every ballot paper has the initial, and what does it say? Every ballot shall bear the stamp and the initial of the speaker. So the speaker is going to put the stamp there and sign it. You see Albans, Kingsford, Sumanu, Bagbin, his signature is there. The initial, is it initial? The stamp and the initial of the speaker. So what's Bagbin? It's A-S-K. Yes, A-S-K-B is going to be on the ballot paper for the appointments committee. That's order 172, subsection 7. Now sit tight and watch order 172, subsection 8. In watching that, think about the numbers of people in parliament. 173, 137, 137. Order 172, subsection 8. Have a look. It says, a candidate who fails to secure 50% of the votes cast is rejected. Very, very direct. Very straightforward. A candidate who fails to secure 50% of the votes cast is rejected. He doesn't end up to go to the committee. A letter will be written to the president, and the president will be told that, Your Excellency, your nomination for Minister for TV had been rejected on the basis that the votes against him, that on the basis that the votes for him was not up to 50%. And it will attach that, Mr. President, please find attached the tallying of the votes that occurred after the votes was taken upon your nominee for Minister for TV. Please kindly nominate another person for Minister for TV. That's what it means. We will come to the numbers on the next page, and you see how closely this parliament has to work and how it was so important for President Akufo-Addo to say at his inaugural that the Ghanaians have thrown an uncharted course, and that between him and ASK Bagbin, they have to find a way to work together for the successful development of this country. This is totally uncharted. Now, what does it mean? It means that out of the 25 members, remember the chairman doesn't have an original vote, and that's in order 211. We don't have it here, but I can read it to you. The chairman of the committee doesn't have an original vote. He only has a casting vote. I'll get there in a minute. It means that, this means that when the votes are taken, and they are 13, 12, or like Paul Adumotri gets 12, and against him is 13, he is not able to secure half of the votes. He stands rejected. The nominee stands rejected if he's not able to get half. We're going to show you the members of this appointment committee. But before then, let's show you the mathematics in the committee right now. What's the mathematics saying? Very, very interesting. This is the mathematics. In the circumstances of the committee and the list that has been published, the National Democratic Congress would have 13 members on the committee. The New Patriotic Party has 13 members of the committee. 13, 13. Of the MPP 13 members, one is the chairman. Joe Osewusu is the chairman of the committee. Have a look at this again. The National Democratic Congress has 13. The NPP has 13. The chairman is MPP. He's one out. And so if you're looking at the voting, you're looking at the voting members, the members that can cast an original vote. And let me explain that. So the original vote is that when we are finished, we vote. That's original vote. The chairman doesn't participate in that. The law does not allow the chairman to participate in the original voting. He's not part of it. So those who are not chairman, the rest of all of them, are going to vote. So this is the number here, 13-13, but what is the number for the original votes cast? Let's look at the next slide. Whoa, there you go. Original voting, NDC 13, MPP 12. That's the original voting. That's what the numbers are throwing up. This is it. NDC 13, MPP 12. That's the original voting. The chairman doesn't have a vote. He doesn't have a vote until there's a tie of sorts, and then he can come in. But he doesn't have an original vote. The chairman, who is one of the MPP people, so that he gets out and MPP become 12, he doesn't have a vote. So in this vetting, the nominees of the president, each nominee of the president will have to do better than 13 and 12. So each nominee of the president will have to get an NDC vote before they can pass the threshold of 50%. Let's go back and read order 172 rule 8. It's here again, put on the screen. A candidate who fails to secure 50% of the vote cast is rejected. That's the situation at the place. A candidate who fails to secure. So you come in here and you see the original votes, NDC 13, MPP 12. That's the point I was making, that if the MPP had known this, they would have allowed the NDC to have the first deputy speaker. In that circumstance, the first deputy speaker would have been here. He's the chairman of the appointments committee, and they would have 12 and they would have 13. As it is, this is what we got. This is what we got. And that's going to be very, very interesting.